Stop saying I love you over and over again to your boyfriend, girlfriend, to your teachers, to other people in English. Guys, there are better ways to express your love, your feelings in English. And in this video lesson, we'll go through over 40 expressions and phrases you can use to express that you love somebody in English. If this is the first time you're here on my YouTube channel, welcome. My name's Adriana from EnglishTeacherAdriana.com, and I help English learners improve their English to boost their confidence to finally speak English confidently. If you'd like to improve your English in less than 30 minutes a day to drastically improve your confidence speaking and communicating in English, make sure to check out the link in the description below this video, where I have a free download, a free audio guide, where I teach you exactly what you need to be doing every single day to improve your English, to boost your confidence, to finally speak English confidently in less than 30 minutes a day. To download your free guide, make sure to click the link in the description, enter your name, your email address, and I will email you this free audio guide. It's not long, guys. It's less than 30 minutes. Listen to it, apply the teachings, principles, and I'm sure you'll be set to drastically improve your confidence speaking in English. Now, guys, saying I love you all the time can be a little bit repetitive, especially if you're in a relationship and maybe your partner would be like, is that all you can say, just that you love me? But why? In this video lesson, we're going to go through different ways, different feelings and emotions you can express yourself to better say, I love you in English. Make sure to watch this whole video lesson a few times, get a pen, get a paper, write them down, and let's begin. Let's go through the different ways to say, I love you in English. Number one, I'm crazy about you. I'm crazy about you. Great phrase to be using if you can't get somebody out of your head. I'm crazy about you. Two, I'm in love with you. I'm in love with you. Great phrase to be using if you've recently discovered that you love somebody. You could express this by saying, I'm in love with you. I'm in love with you. Careful with pronunciation. I'm in love with you. The third phrase, I've got feelings for you. I've got feelings for you. If you're not sure that you love somebody, but you know that there's something there, you could use this phrase, I've got feelings for you, to express that you may love them, you like them, you're not sure, but you know you have some feelings for them. Again, the phrase is, I've got feelings for you. Four, I care about you. I care about you. This phrase is great. You could use it in a romantic setting, but you could also use this in a friendship, in some sort of platonic relationship, to show that you do care about somebody, you like them, but you don't love them. It's not as strong as love, but you do have some feelings for them. Again, I care about you. Five, I've fallen for you. I've fallen for you. Now, if you've recently discovered that you love somebody, great phrase to be using, I've fallen for you, to describe that you simply can't get them out of your head, use this phrase, I've fallen for you. Six, I adore you. I adore you. Careful pronunciation, it's not adore, adore, adore. Now, this is a little bit more formal. I don't use it that often. It is used by many English speakers, but if I do love somebody, then I use the phrase, I love you, instead of I adore. But if you feel that this suits your personality, your character, you can use it, I adore you, I adore you. Seven, you turn me on, you turn me on. Now, this phrase has a real sexual connotation. So if somebody arouses you, you could use this phrase, you turn me on, you turn me on. Careful who you're using this phrase with, as it really does have a strong sexual connotation to it. Again, you turn me on, you turn me on. Eight, I'm head over heels for you. I'm head over heels for you. Great phrase to be using if you can't get somebody out of your head. They're all you can think about, you can't function, you can't do anything, but just think about the fact that you love that person. Use this phrase, I'm head over heels for you. I'm head over heels for you. Number nine, you're the one for me. You're the one for me. Great phrase to be using with your boyfriend, girlfriend, fiance, wife, to express that they're the person that you love. You want to spend your life with them or you just want to be with them. Instead of saying, I love you, you're the one for me. You're the one for me. Or you could also use phrase 10, you're the love of my life. You're the love of my life. Great phrase again to be using with your partner or your soulmate. Number 11, I'm yours. I'm yours. Great phrase to express that you love somebody and you're willing to give yourself to that person. Again, I'm yours. I'm yours. If you can't get somebody out of your head, you could use phrase 10, I'm addicted to you. I'm addicted to you. Honestly, this is a little bit strange to me, but if you feel like the other person, that person that you love, is like a drug to you, you could express this with the phrase, I'm addicted to you. I'm addicted to you. Now, if you're attracted to somebody, you could express this with phrase 12, I'm drawn to you. I'm drawn to you. Great phrase, really formal, really polite, and it's not too abrupt to use this phrase to express that you are attracted to somebody. So, I'm drawn to you, great to be using in a formal setting. Now, phrases 14 and 15 are really sweet. I really like them. And they are, you're my everything, you're my everything, and you're my other half. You're my other half. So this is great to be using in a romantic setting, maybe with your husband and wife, to describe that without them, you're incomplete. Again, you're my everything, or you're my other half. The phrase, I'm smitten with you, means that you can't stop thinking about them. So you're really happy, you love them, you have strong feelings about them. If you'd like to describe this when you're dating somebody for the first time, maybe early on in a relationship, I'm smitten with you, great phrase to be using to express this. It's not so direct and full on as I love you. I'm smitten with you, great to be using in the beginning of a relationship. Again, I'm smitten with you. I'm smitten with you. Another great phrase to be using at the beginning of a relationship could be, every time I see you, I'm left breathless. Every time I see you, I'm left breathless. So if that person that you're dating, that you're seeing, if they really take your breath away, they leave you speechless because you're like, oh my gosh, they're so hot, they're so pretty, etc. You could use this phrase to express that. Again, every time I see you, I'm left breathless. Oh, phrase 18 is so cute. The phrase is, I love you to the moon and back. I love you to the moon and back. If you'd like to express to somebody that you really love them and you'd like to depict this with some sort of a distance, I love you to the moon and back, great phrase to be using to describe that you love them a lot. Phrase 19, you make life worth living, really describes to that person that you'd like to express that you love them, that you do everything that you do, you breathe, you wake up in the morning because you love them. Now, instead of saying you love them, you could use a phrase, you make life worth living. You make life worth living. 20, I love you more than words can say. If you don't have any words to describe how much you love that person, you could use this phrase, I love you more than words can say. I love you more than words can say. Now, 21, you're the peanut butter to my jelly. This one is interesting. So I've heard this a lot in TV shows, in series. Personally, as you can see, I find it funny. My husband came home and told me, Adriana, you're the peanut butter to my jelly. I just laugh at him. Sorry, guys. But you could use this phrase, you're the peanut butter to my jelly, to say that without you, I'm nothing. You know, in American TV shows, so they always eat peanut butter and jelly. This is the connotation of this phrase. You're the peanut butter to my jelly. Great phrase. You can use it. Personally, I find it hilarious. But if you love it, feel free to use it. 22. You make me a better person. You make me a better person. Great phrase to be using if somebody you're seeing, dating, maybe husband and wife, they make you better. So they're constantly improving you, developing you. You feel better that you're with them. Use this phrase. You make me a better person. 23, imagining life without you is impossible. If you can't live without the love of your life, you could use this phrase, imagining life without you is impossible. Again, imagining life without you is impossible. If somebody makes you feel really happy, they shine every time you see them, you see sort of sun rays coming out from them, well, just not literally, but you could use a phrase, you're the light of my life. You're the light of my life. Great phrase to show that you love them, they give you hope, you're the light of my life. If you can't stop thinking about your love, you could use a phrase, you are the only one on my mind. You are the only one on my mind. This shows that you only think about this person, no other ex-boyfriends, ex-girlfriends, etc. You are the only one on my mind. Now, if you've just started dating somebody, you're not sure that you really love them yet, you could use a phrase, I've got a crush on you. I've got a crush on you. Guys, a crush is usually, think about teenagers, when teenagers first start dating, They meet a boy, they meet a girl, they're not too sure if they like, love, whatever. Instead of saying I like or I love them, because they're relatively young, they don't know their feelings exactly, crush is a great phrase, it's a great word to be using instead of love. So if you feel you're a little bit confused whether you like, love, but you know you think about them all the time, you could use this phrase, I've got a crush on you. I've got a crush on you. Now, an informal and really laid back, kick back way of saying that somebody's really taking your heart could be, you got me good. So in this is really, really kick back. If somebody told me this, I'd be like, okay, I wouldn't really know what to think about it. But it's not a bad phrase to be using to express that, you know, you are only thinking about that person, that you do know from this phrase that they like you, they have strong feelings for you. It's not as strong as love, but you got me good. Great way to be expressing that you're thinking about that person and you can only think about that person. Again, you got me good. Next two phrases are so sweet as well. They remind me of primary school. So the phrases are, you are the light of my life and you are my sunshine. Again, you are the light of my life and you are my sunshine. These two phrases are great to express that person brings a lot of hope, a lot of joy, a lot of happiness, a lot of love to your life. Again, the phrases are, you are the light of my life and you are my sunshine. Really great to be using even just in platonic relationships. So if you have a friend that means a lot to you, if you have maybe children that you work with, just to express that you have some sort of love, they bring happiness to your life. Now, if you're really in love with somebody and you feel that you cannot function without them, you could use a phrase, I'm lost without you. I'm lost without you. Great phrase to be using that without them, without loving them, and maybe that relationship, you wouldn't be able to live. Now, phrase 32, you make my heart skip a beat. Great phrase to be using that, you know, your heart beats really fast and even skips a beat. How much you love that person. Again, you make my heart skip a beat. Now, if somebody's really enthusiastic, they make you feel really happy. You may notice that I'm doing a little bit of a dance because with this phrase, you rock my world. Great phrase to express that you love somebody. It can also be in a platonic relationship. To say that that person brings a lot of happiness, joy, dance, laughter to your life. Again, the phrase is, you rock my world. Guys, I hope these phrases will better help you express your love for others. Remember to go out and use these phrases in real life situations to speak more confidently in English. Remember guys, practice is key. Let's express our love for each other in the comments below this video. Choose a phrase that you love, put it in a situation, and show us how you can use these phrases in real life situations. Leave those sentences in the comments below, and let's see how many situations we can get happening there to help us all better remember these phrases and use them when speaking in English. Remember guys, if you like this video lesson, make sure to like it, hit subscribe and turn on notifications so that you get the next lesson that I post here. And if you'd like to better remember any of these new phrases, I do suggest that you watch this video lesson where I share tips how to learn and remember new words in English. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for watching. And I look forward to seeing you in my next lesson. Bye for now.